Welcome back to the channel. I'm glad that you're here. And I have a quick and encouraging word that I wanted to share today. And I pray that the Lord would enable me to release this fully as He intended, and also pray that it would strengthen you and encourage you in the name of Jesus Christ. And what I've been hearing from the Lord is that I have taught you to be abased, and now I will teach you to abound. And He had given me the scripture, Philippians 4, verses 12 through 13. And I'll just quickly read that. This is Paul speaking. And he says, I know how to be abased, and I know how to abound. Everywhere and in all things, I've learned both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And I looked up the word to abase, and the definition is to behave in a way that belittles or degrades. It's from a word that means to lower or means short of stature. And I looked up to abound, and to abound means to be present or exist in large numbers or great quantity, to be copiously supplied. It's from a Latin word, abundare, which means to overflow, to be full, to be plentifully supplied with. And it comes from a root word that means waves, so to rise in waves. So when we're in a place of being abased, we are going low. We are being humbled. We are learning to make by on having very little. And when we are in a place of abounding, we have our needs are abundantly supplied. So we have more than enough. And what Paul was saying here is that he had learned and been strengthened by both. So he had been abased, and he had learned how to go low, and he had abounded, and he had learned how to prosper when he had more than enough. So he basically had learned to go low, he learned to go high, and he had learned to be content in whatever his circumstances. And so what the Lord had been speaking to me is that many of you have been strengthened in a period of being abased. So you've learned how to go low. You've learned how to make by on very little. Maybe when you didn't even know if you would have enough to make it through the next week. Or maybe you just didn't have the things that you needed or that you thought you needed to prosper. And the Lord has strengthened you through that situation in learning that Christ empowered you to be strong and to do well, even through all of that, even through not having enough. But that now He is going to make you even stronger by teaching you how to prosper and do well when you have more than enough. Because they're actually, while you might think it would be the same set of skills, so oftentimes we think, okay, if I know how to get by on very little, then when I have more than enough, I'm going to do really well. I'm really going to prosper, right? Because if I know how to get by on very little, then I'm just going to do great when I have more, finally have more than enough. But actually, it's two separate set of skills that we need to learn. And I was reminded of, and this might help you to understand this, I was reminded of one of my running buddies, my old running buddy, who is a great runner. She's been running for a long time, and she can run really long distances, but she absolutely hates running up hills. And she will do whatever necessary to avoid a big hill. So she would rather add an extra 2 or 3 miles to our run than go up one hill. And so when she had told me that she had signed up for a new race, I wasn't overly surprised when she revealed that she had found a race which was entirely downhill. So I think it was either a half marathon or a marathon that was entirely downhill. The whole route, it started at the top of the mountain and it went down. I think it was in California. And so she was proud of herself that she had found a downhill race, which you would think running downhill, you know, we think of running downhill as being so much easier than running uphill, right? So if you can run 15 or 20 miles on regular terrain, certainly you're going to do well running downhill, right? So I saw her not too long after the race and I asked her, how did it go? And she told me that she was just terribly sore, incredibly sore, much worse than she had imagined, because while you would think running downhill would be easier, if you haven't trained in running downhill and you run 15 or 20 miles downhill, you are using a whole different set of muscles. So it takes different muscles to run downhill than it does to run uphill. So even if you have trained and you're good at running uphill, running 20 miles downhill, it seems like it would come naturally, but actually it's something that you have to train for to get good at. And so that's what the Lord had been speaking to me. Now, there are many of you who may be comfortable with getting by with very little, or, you know, being in situations where you've come from a humble start and you're comfortable with that. But as the Lord is trying to teach you to abound, and the Lord maybe is giving you more, so maybe you've been living off manna and now the Lord is filling your storehouses with grain, and you're getting a little uncomfortable because you're thinking, I'm not sure I know how to do this. I'm not sure how to be successful in this because it's I haven't learned to abound before. And God wanted to encourage you with this. It's Christ who empowers us and gives us that dynamite power. It's Christ who empowers us both to be abased and to abound. So the same Christ who empowered you to make it through the hard times, to make it through the suffering, to make it through the hunger and the lack and the need, that same Christ is the one who will empower you to do well and to succeed when he's calling you into something greater, when he's giving you more and leveling up your responsibility and putting you in a situation to abound and to prosper. When he's putting you in such a situation, he is the same Christ who empowers you to do both. Because in being able to do both, then we are made stronger. And, you know, I watched a show the other day that was a historical show. And in it, it was a gentleman who had married his kitchen maid, which back then, that just didn't happen. You didn't marry people from a different class, and if you did, you would be outcasted, and people just didn't move between the different classes. If you were working class, you were working class. If you were a gentleman or a lady, then you were a gentleman or a lady. Well, he had married a kitchen maid, and so this turned out to be very helpful for him when he fell on hard times, because when he had fallen on hard times, she already knew what to do. She had grown up in a situation where she was used to being hungry. She was used to making by on very little. So when they fell on hard times, she could help him tremendously. She did great. She could survive. She knew what to eat. She knew how to till the land. But when she had to be in circumstances or settings where she was expected not to be the working class maid, but to be the lady of the house, it became much more challenging for her. It was much less comfortable for her to be in a position of abounding. So she had to learn how to direct the workers what to do, because she was used to being the worker and she had never been in that situation. She had to learn how to speak and how to behave in certain company, in finer company. She had to learn how to behave so she could learn both to abase and to abound. And eventually she did. And that's how Paul was. So Paul could walk into any situation and he knew how to do both. He could walk into a situation where times were hard and there wasn't enough, and he could be content. He knew he had the strength he needed in Christ, and that Christ was his all sufficiency. And he knew how to walk into a situation where he was talking with the, you know, chief Pharisees or the leaders of the Jews, or he was talking with kings or any company. He could walk into that company and be comfortable. So he knew how to do both. And that's what I heard the Lord saying, is that he's teaching many of you who may be uncomfortable with taking on more and having more responsibility and being in a higher position, he will strengthen you and teach you how to do that, because your strength is in the Lord. And he also had given me just a few keys regarding how to be successful in this. And first of all, it's knowing that our power comes from Christ, our ability comes, our strength comes from the Lord. And then he had given me the scripture, Psalm 50, verse 14, which says, "Make thankfulness your sacrifice to God and keep the vows you made to the Most High." So it's going to be key when we are brought into a situation where we have more than enough, where we're abounding, it's going to be key that we remain thankful. That we remain thankful for what God has given us, and that we continue to recognize the source, and that whatever we have is from the Lord. And also that we keep the vows we made. So what does that mean? So there are many of you who maybe need to remember some of the vows you made to the Lord. So going back, you may have made vows in your suffering, in your lack. You may have said, you may have even cried out and said, "God, if you save me out of this situation, Lord, I promise I will go out and tell everyone about you. I will tell everyone and lift your name on high." So you may have made that vow, and now God has saved you out of that situation. So don't forget your vow that you made to him. Don't forget your vow. Now that you're out of your difficulty and your trouble, that vow you made to the Lord, you may have been in a situation where you were, you know, depressed or totally downcast or, you know, troubled in some way. And you cried out to the Lord and you said, "God, if you deliver me out of this, I promise I will go and help other people. I promise I will go and help my brothers and my sisters who are suffering with the same thing." Or you may have said, "God, if you get me out of poverty, I will go. I promise I will give. I promise I will help lift others up who need a helping hand and help them to step up." So whatever vow you made to the Lord when you were in your time of need, remember that when you have been brought into your time of plenty, that you may fulfill those vows that you made to the Lord, because that's very important, because the Lord hasn't forgotten them. And then also, we're to trust in God. We're not to trust in our riches. We're not to trust in the resources or the things God has given us. Always, we're to keep our trust on God. And this is from 1 Timothy 6. "Teach those who are rich in this world not to be proud and not to trust in their money, which is unreliable. Their trust should be in God, who richly gives us all we need for our enjoyment." And that's verse 17. And Finally, use what God gives you to do good. Use what God gives you to help others to do good deeds. And it says this further down in 1 Timothy 6, verse 18. Be rich in good works and generous to those in need, always being ready to share with others. So as the Lord blesses you, be ready to then turn around and bless others and to share with others. And finally, be content in whatever the circumstance. Be content. And I'm going to read two scriptures here. True godliness with contentment is itself great wealth. True godliness with contentment is itself great wealth. 1 Timothy 6:6. And then this is from Philippians 4:11. For I have learned in whatever state I am to be content. Content. So be content. Whatever state this video finds you in today, whether you are being abased in your current situation, whether you are bounding, know that the same Christ will strengthen you through both of them, and he will give you power and supply everything that you need. And he is strengthening you to learn. He is teaching you and instructing you how to be content and how to do well in both of those situations, so that whatever life throws at you, you will be ready. You will be ready to prosper regardless of the circumstances. You will be comfortable with very little, and you will also be comfortable and learn the skills that you need to do well with having more than enough. And many of you may have been strengthened even through rejection or learning to make your face like flint and to just keep moving forward. When things were really hard, you made your face like flint and you didn't turn away. You kept moving forward. Maybe when people rejected you, maybe when people spoke against you, maybe when people turned against you, when you walked through hard circumstances where you were alone, you learn to be strong in that. You learn to be strong in those situations because you turn to Christ for your strength. But the Lord is saying to you now, I am going to make you even stronger by learning how now to be loved, how now to be accepted, how now to be in a place where your needs are supplied and you have more than enough. So I will make you even stronger in that. I will strengthen you even more in that. So you've learned how to do both. You've learned how to abase, and now you will learn how to abound, because I will teach you, says the Lord. So I pray this has blessed you, and I also pray, if this word is meant for you, that it would just be sealed in your heart and it would grow up and bear much fruit in the name of the Lord, that it would prosper in the name of the Lord. And I'll talk with you next time. Bye.